little privacy, please.
If you want more privacy on the internet, the operating system that you choose plays a crucial role.
There are many different operating systems. Two of the most common ones are Microsoft Windows and Mac OS.
We've all heard of Windows and Mac, but there are many other operating systems out there, like the various versions of Linux. And then there's a little known one called Tails, the operating system that puts privacy first. It stands for the Amnesiac Incognito Live System, and it's a free, open source operating system. To be honest, it isn't the fastest or most convenient OS. It's an extreme privacy measure, but it's great for high-risk people like activists and journalists. Tails aims to do the right thing right out of the box by default, to protect less tech-savvy users from the most likely and highest impact risks to their privacy. For example, all connections are forced to go through the Tor network, which helps you use the internet anonymously and circumvent censorship. And DuckDuckGo is set as the default search engine, which is renowned as one of the better search engines for privacy. It uses state-of-the-art cryptographic tools to encrypt files, emails, and instant messaging. And one of the most interesting features of Tails, it's designed to wipe the memory of your computer every time you log off. It leaves no trace of any work that was done on the computer, unless the user explicitly asks it to. So, every file you've downloaded or app you installed during your session will have disappeared when you log back in. Let's say you had confidential information you wanted to share with a journalist. You'd boot up Tails, upload your confidential document to a secure drop site, and then shut down, destroying any trace of what you just did. Now, don't be scared off. This isn't just a hardcore tool that only activists should use. It's actually surprisingly easy to boot up once you have it installed, and it can be used by anyone who wants more privacy when they use the internet. And it doesn't require you to buy a whole new computer either. You don't actually install Tails onto your computer. It boots instead from an external storage device, like a DVD, USB stick, or an SD card instead. It can be used on your existing Mac, Windows, or Linux computers. The only aspect of the computer actually used by Tails is the computer's memory. When Tails shuts down, the memory is erased, which erases any traces of that user. I'll show you step by step how to install and use Tails, and then I'll go over some important tips and warnings that you need to be aware of when using it.
And here we go.
We'll break down the installation into 5 parts, and it's helpful to have a mobile phone or a separate computer handy so that you can view the instructions from the official Tails website while you complete the process. Step 1, the download. Go to the official Tails website and select the correct Tails software for the computer type that you'll be using. I'm using a Mac computer, but the install process for different machines is similar. Download the disk image straight onto your computer. Then you need to verify your Tails disk image that you just downloaded. Once it's verified, it's on to step 2, the installation. You'll need your external storage device handy. I used a USB stick. Go ahead and plug it in. To install Tails to your USB stick, you can use the command line. But if you're like me and not particularly comfortable with that, then you can instead use the program Etcher to assist with the installation. So download the Etcher app, drag it into your applications, and open it. Inside Etcher, you'll click the Flash from File button and choose the Tails disk image that you downloaded earlier. Click the Select Target button and choose your USB stick. Click Flash and fill in your password. The installation takes a few minutes, and when it's done, you can close Etcher. Now it's time to restart your computer, booting Tails for the first time using your USB stick. Shut down the computer with the USB stick still plugged in. Then hit the computer startup button and immediately press the Option or Alt key. A list of possible startup disks will appear. Select your USB and hit Enter. Tails will start to boot, and after a couple of minutes, the welcome screen appears. You're in!
It's alive! It's alive!
Step 4 is where you'll configure Tails. Choose the appropriate settings on the welcome screen, and then click Start Tails. Your computer will want to connect to the internet, but be aware that problems with Wi-Fi are very common in Tails, so I highly recommend that you connect your computer using Ethernet. Tails should automatically detect your Ethernet connection and open up a window to help you connect to Tor. The Tor settings you choose will depend on your own security preferences. And once you've set that up, you're free to browse the internet. Now, we mentioned that Tails automatically deletes everything on your system as soon as you log off. This is to help hide your identity, but there might be a reason why you want to have persistent files on your computer, like a document that you're working on, or a particular app that you frequently use. Tails does give you a way to create persistent storage, but just make sure that you understand the risks involved before enabling this. To add persistent storage, go to Applications and select Configure Persistent Volume. Add in a passphrase, then hit Create. There are many different persistent storage features that you can use, but the official Tails website recommends that you only turn on the personal data feature to start with and enable other features later on. Save your selection, and then final step, restart your computer by again immediately holding the Option or Alt key after. This time on the welcome screen, you will unlock your persistent storage section by typing in your passphrase, then start Tails. All your persistent files can be saved under Places and in the Persistent folder. I tested it out and saved a text document inside the Persistent folder and also copied and saved it inside the Regular Documents folder. When I restarted my computer, the document had indeed disappeared from the Regular folder, but it was still saved there in the Persistent folder. That's your whole setup for Tails. Now you can reboot from your USB stick whenever you want more privacy. The Tails official website has a fantastic troubleshooting section in their instructions that I've linked below in case you run into any issues.
What lights are lit on your console?
Now that you have Tails, what can you do on it? Actually, most of the things that you do on your normal computer. In Applications, you'll find a bunch of programs pre-installed, like LibreOffice, a Windows Office alternative, Mozilla Thunderbird, an email provider, KeePass XC, a password manager, and Pigeon Internet Messenger. There are even programs like Audacity for recording audio and the Electrum Bitcoin wallet. This system is ready to plug and play with almost everything that you need. But some important tips to remember. Make sure that you're only using your Tails session for one use at a time, or an adversary could link your different activities together. For example, by logging into different accounts on the same website, that website could figure out that the accounts are used by the same person. This is because websites can tell when two accounts are using the same Tor circuit. Always restart Tails between different activities. For example, between checking your work email and checking your whistleblower email. Sharing photos or documents with metadata embedded in it, such as date, time, location, and device, can also expose your identity. If you want to learn how to scrub your metadata, I have a video that walks you through some easy steps. Finally, Tails provides upgrades every 6 weeks, so you need to re-download Tails every 6 weeks if you want to keep your security strong. My takeaways from using Tails. To be honest, I was expecting the setup process to be far scarier than it was. The operating system is actually really intuitive and functions very similarly to my normal system. I do find that everything is much slower when using Tails, but honestly, for the security that I'm getting, this really doesn't bother me at all. And I personally love extreme privacy measures, but it's important to ask yourself before using it, which part of my threat model makes this necessary? Having an operating system that fits in a pocket versus carrying around a laptop is also incredibly handy for someone who wants to keep themselves safe and untrackable. Award-winning journalist Glenn Greenwald said that Tails have been vital to my ability to work securely on the NSA story. The more I've come to learn about communication security, the more central Tails has become to my approach. He's not the only one who swears by it. Snowden once tweeted, "The absolute most important thing that you can do to maintain your anonymity is reduce the number of places in your operational activity where you can make mistakes." Tor and Tails still do precisely that.
I go by Ed. Edward Joseph Snowden's the full name.
And when the Academy Award-winning documentary Citizen 4 was being made about the Snowden revelations, director Laura Poitras was dealing with highly sensitive data, including all the raw interview footage with Snowden himself. Tails was essential to the making of that documentary. But perhaps you're not an activist or dissident, but you just find the idea of surveillance of everything you do on the internet incredibly distasteful. Tails might still be an interesting tool for you to use, especially when running it is as simple as pressing the Alt key on startup. So give Tails a try. You might actually be pleasantly surprised.
You have chosen wisely.